Good morning.
Good morning.
I will be reading from Psalm 108, verse 1 through 5. Please stand for the reading of God's word. O God, my heart is fixed, and I will sing and give you praise even with my words. Awake softly and heart. I myself will awake early. I will praise thee, O Lord, among the people, and I will sing praises until thee among the nations. For thy mercy is great above the heavens, and thy truth reaches unto the clouds. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens, and thy glory above the earth. I just read Psalm 108, verse 1 through 5. Thank you.
Now I need you to look at your name and say, well, it's 2013. 2013. Look at your other name and say, 2012 is gone.
2012
is gone. Act like it's 2013.
Act like it's 2013.
In the name of Jesus. I don't know about you, but 2012 was a rough year. I said 2012 was a rough year. But if you know like I know, I'm so glad it's behind me now. Because God has given me a new chance in 2013. Said in the name of Jesus. I'm excited today. Just in case you didn't know. Look at your neighbor and say, are you excited? Because I have a whole lot to be excited for. You woke me up this morning. You not sent me on my way. I could have ran off the road and taken my way. I could have gotten an accident for the snow the other day. But he woke me here today. I got a lot to be excited about.
Hey,
I know we have communion today, but let me get to my business. If you have your word, it's going to be in Luke, the 15th chapter. Beginning at the 11th verse, I'm going to read a couple. I'm not going to read it from 11 to 13. Y'all. So, stand if you have your word, Luke 15, the 11th chapter. Luke 15, beginning at the 11th verse. I'm going to be reading out of the King James Version. As you can see, I'm going to try something new today. I have transitioned to the electronic world. But I got my Bible yesterday. In the name of Jesus. And it reads. And he said, a certain man had two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of good that falleth to me.
Yes.
And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country. And they wasted, somebody said wasted, his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land. Look at your neighbor and say, that's when the devil comes, when you've been through your stuff.
That's when the devil comes, when you've been through your stuff.
And then it says, and when he has spent all their roles and mighty family in that land, and he began to be in Rome, and he went and joined with them who were citizens of that country, and he sent him into his field to feed swine. And he would have faint and filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. And he gave when he came to himself. And he said, how many hired servants of my father have bread enough and to spare? And I have it with hunger. I will arise and go to my father and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants. Skip down to verse 24. Just like God. He says, for this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And they begin to be men. I want to talk just for a little while to my young folks and to my old folks. Just for a little while on the topic of you made that baby. But you don't have to leave. Let me say that again. I said, you made that bed, but you don't have to lay in it. Let us pray to Father in the name of Jesus. Father, I come to you right now. God, asking you to remove Anthony Williams and place your servant instead. God, give me the boldness to say what it is you would have me to say. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I got to be honest with you. But when God gave me this message, this is one of those messages that he possibly gives to you. I said 2013. It's one of those messages that you preach at the beginning of the year. Simply put, because 2012 is gone. We in a new year. And when I asked God, I said, God, I don't want to preach this. But look, because it sounds like you're saying that folks can do what they want to do and get away with it. And I said, that don't sound right. I go to church every Sunday. I pray and do all these things. And you want me to tell folks that they made some beds, that they don't have to lay in?
No,
he said, yes. And me and God have these conversations. And so he said, I said to him, he said to me, he said, did I make you lay in every bed that you ever made? And I said, me being me now, I'm just telling you how I talk to him. I said, yes, you did, God. I'm one of those ones that folks that thought I never. Every time I did something, it feels like I got caught. And he made me pay the price for what I did. I don't know about you. But then you know God has a funny way of reminding you that you're not all that. And that you ain't been saved all your life. And so he reminded me, let me put in your Blu-ray DVD of your life. And I said, okay. And he reminded me. When you were at ECU, how many women did you mess with? I said, plenty, God. He said, did I give you any diseases? I said, well, thank you, Jesus. He said, you know, when you got in all those fights, when you were down at the courthouse, when you were getting ready to go to jail, how many days did you stay in jail? I said, well, God, I didn't stay a day in jail. He said, so did I make you lay in every day that you made? And I kind of told myself, and I fell to my knees, and I said, thank you, God. So now when I look back over my life, I realize that it was plenty of beds that you didn't make. You have to look at your neighbor and say, I thank God that I didn't have to lay in all those beds. And this is what God is so good about. You know, when you look at a bed, you know beds come in all different sizes. You can go down to a twin bed, to a California king. And you can bed and tell the difference is, it don't matter how big or small your bed was. Just realize that you made some beds that you didn't have to lay in. And so finally, when I said, God, after he did all that and he took me back to memory lane and said, now, do you remember some days? And I was thinking, people don't say, you know what, you alright, because since you've been saved, it's bad that, you know, you've been good, and then God has a way of punching you, giving you a good punch, and he showed me some things that I've done since I've been saved, and then I really had to say, God, I thank you, see, because sometimes the bed we make is after Sunday service, sometimes the bed we make is after Bible study, sometimes the bed you make is after coming off a fast, see, sometimes it's not the sinner that you have to worry about, sometimes it's us, the lay Christian folks, that God has to remind us.
Oh,
So I said, you got to break this down to me. Because folks ain't going to understand me. And so I said, make it plain for me. And he said, plain simply stands for bad emotional decisions. Let me say that again. He said, bad simply stands for bad emotional decisions. And all of us have made some bad emotional decisions. And so now we got all the preliminary out of the way. Now we can get to the story of the prodigal son. It's one of my favorite stories.
Yes.
Simply put, because I have been a prodigal. I have done some stuff. I have been outside the will of God. And if you think this story does not apply to you, then you're wrong yourself. Simply put, guess what? Even when you're waiting to do it, and see, sometimes God had to show me that you can be in church and not in church. What do you mean? You can be going through the motions of church and not doing this. And see, he showed me. He said, you know, you were saved a long time. You were in your calling, but what purpose is your calling? I said, okay, God. So he said, you were in church, but wasn't in church. And so as I got forward, I said, okay, God. Enough about me. Because I'm tired of you giving me, God. So I understand. I'm just a humble servant that you're trying to use. I understand that I'm not perfect. And so he said, oh, dear, tell my young folks that they made some bed in 2012 that they don't have to lay in. Maybe your poor was not where you wanted to be, but that was 2012. This is 2013. We're moving forward, simply put, because we can. As we go forward, the Bible says that there was a father with two sons. Older son, and some about them young sons. The young ones, they always give you trouble. It's something about as parents get old. I tell my mama all the time, if you had done to them what you did to me, see, because some of the stuff they get away with, my younger brother got away with. I'd have been in the hospital simply because I would have got a whooping out of sight of a whooping. But as they get older, you know, they said the more kids you have, when you get to that last kid, it's just time. Don't do what you don't do. And so as we got here, that you agree with that, little Rick, and let you get away, and them get away with stuff, right? That they don't let them get away with. That's right. As we go.
Amen.
Amen. And so the younger son said to his father, he said, Father, give me my stuff. And so as we go, let me tell you about the beds that we make and how you have to understand when you're making a bed. So the first thing you have to understand is you have to understand what you're asking for. Let me say that again. Understand what you're asking for. If you look at this, he said, give me my stuff. So what did he really want? What he really wanted was his stuff with no responsibility. And so you have to understand what you're asking for.
Amen.
Sometimes the worst thing that God can do for us is give us what we want. Let me say that again. I say sometimes the worst thing that God can do is give us what we want. Simply because when you sometimes God steps back and say you want it so bad, I will give it to you to show you that it's really not what you want. And so even though this was unusual, a request, it was legal. And so he asked his daddy to give him his stuff. I want to say something. We begin to make bad emotional decisions the minute we become restless. Young folks, don't become restless. I said, don't become restless. Understand that the greatest thing you have going for you now is the fact that you feel young. Because you don't have a whole lot of responsibilities now. You think you have responsibilities. You think taking out the garbage is a responsibility. You think cleaning up your room is a responsibility. You think watching your little sister. You think that's a responsibility. But wait till the IRS calls you. Wait till the man at the job calls you. Wait till you have to get up every morning. You know, right now, you know, you don't feel good. Mama might let you stay from school. But guess what? When you in the world, when you have responsibilities, the man called Forbes don't wait on you. He don't care if you sick. He don't care if what's going on. They so old-fashioned. They just ain't with the times. Let me tell you something. We've been through it, got the t-shirt, and all we're trying to do is show you. Look, I'm going to tell you the same thing I went through. We start making plans. The minute we get restless, the minute that we think we know more than the people that's trying to take care of us. See, because I tell mine all the time. Anytime you want to switch, anytime you want to make the mortgage payment, you just let me know. I'll clean your room. I'll go sit in the classroom for you. I'll do whatever you need me to do. Just to pay your mortgage.
Go ahead.
Right. So I tell them, anytime you want me to make that switch,
I know that's right.
Just let me know. I'm ready. I need a break.
Right.
Amen. But you got to understand what you're asking for. And what he was asking for here was his stuff.